Let's look at the solution for the part 3 of our one cycle quiz, which is about if this is the state at the beginning of the cycle, then during this cycle, which, if any, instruction will dispatch into the ALU here. And this instruction we already saw in part 2 is going to free its reservation station, and it's already executing, so it will definitely not dispatch again. This instruction here will capture its last remaining operand during this cycle, so it becomes eligible for dispatch after that. We said that in the same cycle, capture and then dispatch is allowed, so this instruction here is a candidate for dispatching. We are also going to issue this instruction here into a reservation station, but because the issue and then dispatch is not allowed in the same cycle, that means that this instruction, even if its operands were ready, would not be eligible for dispatch now. So the only instruction eligible for dispatch is this one, which means that that's the one that gets to dispatch. If more than one instruction were eligible for dispatch, then we would have to pick which one dispatches because we only have one execution unit. And in order to do that, we would actually need to be told what are the rules for picking among instructions. Fortunately, we didn't need that because only one is eligible for dispatch.